Hello everybody, and welcome back to Jackwall Let's Play Euro Truck Simulator 2. We've just had a rest. We're going to get ourselves sorted. We don't need that anymore, so we can start the engine. Let's get rid of that. Go away. Turn on some lights. Take off our handbrake. Turn on an indicator. Check rear. Car coming up here actually. So we'll wait for that to go out. Because we're nice, good drivers. And away we go. So we're on the road again. Now we do have a little bit of a distance to go still. We've got 1100 kilometers, 17 hours, 18 hours of driving actually. We've got a full slot of 11 to do, so we're going to see if we can bring this down and complete this journey within, with two stops, the next one and then be done with the next session. Two sessions, not two stops, two sessions. That is the plan. This is us heading down the road. Weaving all over the place. I find it quite difficult driving out here. But it's nice to have a look at the truck and see what it's like. Oh god. Right, back into the cab, because that's just ridiculous. I'll have to get better at that, actually. I believe there's a drive-by camera, actually. Hang on. The option is... The graphics? No. It's no graphics. It's, controls? Is there a controls for a view of the camera? Or is that a mod that I've got to download? Yeah, you know what, it's actually probably a mod that I've got to download, so we won't bother. We'll do our external shots from stationary, because you know, it's kind of safer for other road users than me weaving all over the place as we're heading down the road. So anyway, we're going pretty well. I'm still proceeding down the road to try and get this load delivered in preparation for a skin that is being built for me. And I've actually got a little bit of a sneak preview at the skin. It was a work in progress. It was a kind of a test skin, really. I haven't really spoken back with Charlie on that. I've sent him an email reply with some feedback. But it's looking good. The resolution of the skin images that he's put up is fantastic, actually. It's all nice and neat and clean. A few little details that need to be changed, but he's a busy guy. He's got lots of things going on, I think, and so I don't know how much time he has for building this, but there's no rush. We're going to be doing quite a bit of driving in this truck, and one of the feedback things that I suggested to him is that he gets his channel onto the front of the truck so that I can advertise his channel a little bit. That way he'll he'll be able to get something out of this as well, which is important, basically, because he's going to be doing quite a bit of work to make this skin kind of nice and neat, so he should be putting up the channel. He should be getting, sorry, the credit for it by getting his channel advertised. So what I'm thinking of doing, actually, is taking a few screenshots and doing a few edits so that he gets a feel for what the skin would look like. And, yeah. And that way, then, he can go and build the skin and everything will be cool. So, I gotta pull over here again. It seems to be a regular occurrence now. We're stuck on the Fletchers. We'll bring it over to a stop here, because I've got a little bit of an interruption. It's an important interruption, though. It's not a problem. and I will come back to you soon. Okay, everybody, I'm back after that little bit of an interruption, and we are on the road again. I'd like to give a shout out to one of my latest subscribers, Julian Mons. Here's a link to the channel. Different videos on there. Do drop on and have a look-see and see what you think. But cheers, dude, for the subscription. Much appreciated. So that was a little short interruption that I had, which is now dealt with, and we won't be doing an awful lot of more driving this evening. I've got a pretty early morning to deal with tomorrow morning, and it means getting up at about 5, and I need my beauty sleep. So we are going to do a little bit more as the driving here, and Dan's going to go sleep. 9 hours from 16, with another stop somewhere in the middle here if we do a full stint, we'll be able to make our delivery fairly comfortably at the end of the next driving session. So that's cool. That could be good. And then we can get this digger delivered to Faro, and we can go and pick up something cool, something decent. My fuel is under half now, but we should have enough juice to get there. We have 1500 kilometers in the tank, 600 liters, with a distance of 900 kilometers to go, so we're good on fuel. And after the next rest stop, we will have the delivery done. And then the question is, where will we be with Charlie Hurst's skin? And how much more time will be needed? There is plenty of time, actually. There's no rush for this. I'll probably be waiting for that skin to come on so that I can get it uploaded, and then we'll head back out on the road. Probably heading down back to North Africa again, I reckon. And we'll be holding out still for that AI update, maybe a bit of a physics update as well. Who knows what'll happen between now and the next videos. I have a bit of work to do, a bit of travel, so I'm not going to be playing quite as much. And there's a few other games that I was talking about in the last video that I'm keen to get a little bit of time on as well. So what does that mean for ETS2? Well, that means that ETS2 has a little bit of competition in terms of the available time that I have. But it also means that I'll be keeping ETS2 fairly fresh for me. And it'll just mean that the videos that I am making for ETS2, they'll continue just at a slightly slower rate. Or maybe they won't, actually, because the way I'm kind of doing it at the moment is I record most of my sessions, and I just burn the videos in the evening time. So actually, given the way that I'm planning on doing it, it shouldn't really have an impact on the videos at all. If anything, they should stay the same. That's the rate at which I'm producing them. The change will be that on my channel I will be switching between the different games that I'm playing, the different simulators that I have up. There'll be a few more of the flying sims going up. I'd like to get a little bit of Arma 3 showing as well with the clan once we get ourselves back into operation. And maybe over the Christmas winter kind of period I will sort out the rig for driving. So I'll be able to bring a few more a Richard Byrne rally and a few more All Factor. Probably some race to play sessions out. I need to work out how best to do that because recording All Factor is presently a little bit of a problem. Excuse me? It tends to seriously hit my frame rate when I'm using craps. But I have a plan. It's a brilliant plan. It's not even my original idea. There's another YouTuber out there, Fan Thomas, who pretty good racer now. He's a fairly dedicated race to play simmer, and he's a pretty consistent driver. He's a pretty clean racer. Maintains a good respect within the community. He's certainly, you know, up there as one of the leading lights in terms of quality racers to be racing against. I've had the pleasure of racing against him a couple of times. Not that I've ever seen much of him, because he's been up front and I've been down in the back, certainly from midfield anywhere back to the last person on the track. But he would have lapped me probably a couple of times. But anyway, he has a number of videos up on his channel, which a lot of them are coming from Race to Play, where he does 15 and 20 minute cuts of his racing videos. Some of the races can be 45 minutes, some of them are even longer. He doesn't put up, you know, the full race. But anyway, well, what's my point here? My point is that he has a cockpit view. He plays off of a big screen TV, and the camera is set up behind him and over his shoulder, such that he's really got it spot on, because it'll fool you into thinking that he's really sitting in the car, but for the graphics. And the graphics are fairly decent. The angle of the camera means that you get to see his steering wheel and his shifter, as well as the rendered cockpit on the screen, coupled with obviously the racetrack and anything that's going on. So he pulls that into a digital camera and then processes that and puts it up on YouTube. And the end result is a pretty enjoyable view. Coupled with his driving skill, it makes for some decent videos. So I got a bit of work to do on the skill side of things, but I reckon I could do the rest of it as well. I do have a big screen relatively here. It's not as big as his, although there's an idea there. There might be a TV freeing up kind of thing. We'll have to see. But if that was to happen, then I would need to get the camcorder. And I don't think I need to go and be spending stupid amounts of money on it either. Although I think I'd like to get a HD. Try and maximize out on the quality as much as I can for whatever price point I decide on. And then it's a case of getting some of those videos done. That is the plan. It's a brilliant plan, but there's no real schedule on when I'll be able to achieve it. Then of course there's Silent Hunter 3, which I've begun a career on, but I haven't really completed the training yet. I need to find some time to round robin on that. What else? Farming Simulator 2013. So I have great intentions on getting back into that, but I guess there's some higher priorities on my gaming, and my gaming time is relatively limited. Of recent, I've been free quite a few of the evenings to do a bit, but I need to, I need to ration that back a little bit. Because there's a few other priorities that are important to me that I need to be paying more attention to now. So yeah, and then of course, there's Star Citizen, which is yet to arrive to a PC near you. But the hangar module is already out. There's a dogfighting module that is due next, and it's not so far away. And then there's other aspects and other sections, I suppose. Or patches or releases or components of the game. Components, I suppose, is the right way to describe it. There's a number of them that will come out and build up the universe and build up the planet side and build up the rest of the ships and so on and so forth during the course of 2014 and 2015. Should see us playing the game, and I have a feeling that that's going to command quite a bit of time as well, so I'm trying to get into a rhythm to prepare for that, which my worry is that there's too much to do, so I may have to make some hard decisions. I can't really see ETS2 being a game that I will forget about. I think this is going to certainly be one of the games that I'm going to continue playing for quite a while. So that's going to charge out some of my gaming time. Leaves enough time for, I would say, at least two or maybe three other games. The flying as a genre of playing is something that I want to continue. Now there's Cliffs of Dover, World War II fighter dogfighting game. It's got the Team Fusion Patch 4, as I talked about in the last video. And I have the computer to drive it, so it's all pretty fantastic. It's really enjoyable, so that's definitely got to be played. And it's being played online with the ATAG server guys, so most all of the time it's person versus person, which, yeah, it makes for some very dynamic gameplay and lots of opportunity for me to improve. There's also Flight Simulator X, which is a little bit more seriously minded for me. I'm thinking about maybe doing an air hauler career and treating that as a flight every so often, once in a while, but not a very regular thing. So over the course of a year I might build up a small library of flights using Flight Simulator X and the air hauler patch or add-on. And then there's Black Shark from DCS, which I think I'll be playing less of, but I would like to keep my hand into that a little bit, just to fly around a little bit more. And, you know, there's an A-10 in that game as well, which if I had more time, I would spend more time investing in playing that. But that covers the flying genre. The driving genre has predominantly R-Factor, and Richard Burns Rally. I've played around a little bit with Codemasters. It's an arcade game at the end of the day that looks fantastic, but I just can't get to it. I've actually got most of the Codemasters things. I've actually bought every game. The last couple I've waited for the price to come down a little bit, but the first two I bought immediately upon release, and I've played them quite a bit, and they're good games, so credit where credit is due. But for me, with Race to Play and R-Factor, that does it perfectly, and that's kind of where I think I'm going to stay. And of course, R-Factor 2 is not there yet. R-Factor 2 is not there yet, but it's knocking on the door, and maybe it will get there eventually. But it has a lot of work to do to take the crown away from the original R-Factor, still, to be honest with you. And some of the mod community mods that have been added for R-Factor are still leading the way, notwithstanding the age of the engine and the game. Richard Burns Rally, along with the French patching and the French mod, Auris Orbior, that's just still leading the pack in terms of rally driving. Again, not trying to pick on Codemasters, but they've brought out that very successful franchise Dirt. It's a fun arcade drive, and it's probably more than an arcade drive if you want to treat it properly, but yeah, it doesn't take the crown away from Richard Farnes' rally and what the Auris Orbiaor guys have done with Richard Farnes' rally. So, yeah, that's about it. And there's quite a bit of variety in both the original Ore Factor and Richard Farnes' rally in terms of different vehicles and different tracks and stuff. So, much to be excited about there, and of course, if Ore Factor 2 does take off, then the future is secure as well. So that's the second genre. I suppose we would put Euro Truck Simulator 2 into the driving genre as well, naturally. Yeah, that's fair to say. So, what does that leave us with? Well, that leaves us with the kind of the other end, and that is Arma 3. And I really enjoy Arma 3. I play with a clan online, and it's all about teamwork and having a bit of fun and simulating what's going on. And my intention there is kind of to play the game sessions with these guys regularly, make some recordings if everybody agrees to that and they're happy with me doing it, and build up a small library of playing Arma 2. I don't think it's going to be anything like Dyslexies or some of the other clans that are out there. That's not the intention. The intention of my channel is still a library that I've built up for my own satisfaction to look back on later. But within reason, you know, I hope that there's a degree of quality to show off. And Arma certainly is, you know, a first-person shooter that I find interesting. I've played the Call of Duties and I've enjoyed them, and they're done. And I have no interest in taking it back off the shelf and playing it again. Although, never say never. With Arma 3, the clock has been set back quite a bit regarding the mods and the various components that have become a mainstay in Arma 2. Acre, for example, is working for Arma 3. There's a solution in place, but it's a bit hit and miss still. At least it is as of December 2013. So I'm hoping to see that improve and, you know, just generally get more easy to set up and more reliable. And it will. There's absolutely no doubt about it. It will. I think the Arma community has transferred mostly over to Arma 3 now. I think that significant step has occurred. There's still quite a bit of Arma 2 being played, no doubt, and Arma 2 probably will continue for quite some time, but I think consensus is that Arma 3 is where it's at. That was tight, but it was okay. It was controlled. Stupid car. So then there's a few little other things that are around. That's kind of three areas, right? There's driving, there's flying, and there's first-person shooter. That's three genres, of which there's more than three games covering the three genres. So I'm not sure that's going to leave an awful lot of time for very much else. But whatever time is left over, I would like to prioritize Silent Hunter 3. That for me is a game which, when I'm in the mood, it can test my mettle, my mental calculations, my nerve, so to speak, when played in a realistic kind of simulation type of mindset. It's a game that I wouldn't be using the external view with. I'd be setting the difficulties to difficult, the max of difficulty, such that if I make a mistake, it's likely going to end my career. And I think I'd almost start out with the mindset of, I have one attempt to play this game. That's probably going a little too hard, but, you know, that would be a mindset to take with it. I have one attempt to see how far I can get in this game, see if I can survive through 39, through 40, into 41, or however far Silent Hunter 3 takes me. I have Silent Hunter, I have all the Silent Hunter franchise. So there's potential for that to stretch out for quite a while. I wouldn't be playing it every day, or perhaps not even every week. But over the course of the year, I might expect to make some progress in my career. It is the type of a game that, of course, you need to be fluent with, but it's not in the same sense as what Arma 3 would determine, would demand from you if you're playing in a clan, where you've kind of got to stay up on top of your aiming and your shooting, as well as remembering the hotkeys and what to do. I think there's a little bit more skill. Well, maybe skill is not the right word, because there's skill in both games. But just the type of skills that you need in Arma, I think they require regular, constant touching. Whereas perhaps the same is not exactly true for Silent Hunter. I think you can leave that for a little while longer and come back and pick it up from where you left off. And I'm playing it single player anyway, so the dynamic of the game would be completely different. So that would maybe be kind of number four, priority number one. And then for fun, and there won't be very much time for this, but the farming simulator would come in. But that leaves one big problem, you see, and that is Star Citizen, because I haven't accounted for that at all. And Star Citizen will become a priority when it matures. So, now Star Citizen, I need to work out, you know, the extent to which I will play that game, how much time I can afford for it, and part of that is the reason why I'm talking about this plan now. Apportioning my gaming time in such a way that I can get into some kind of a rhythm, so that I can make progress in the games that I want to make progress in. That would mean Euro Truck Simulator would get one night of playing, you know, probably every 2 weeks. Which doesn't sound like an awful lot, given that there have been weeks when I've played it every night. I don't really play an awful lot on most weekends, and I usually sit down to play for an hour or so of an evening, so actually, you know, I could still get an awful lot done within ETS 2, but I'll be going at my own speed, as opposed to, you know, covering 100% of the map faster, or different types of loads, or opening up different garages and so on and so forth, or whatever. Right, as usual, I ran out of space on my disk again. I'm gonna have to work a better solution to get a little bit more disk space for recording. We've driven down to about 4.5 hours left, 279 kilometers from our destination. I babbled away until I got here, unaware of the fact that my fraps had stopped recording as usual. But anyway, that's our status, and this is where we're going to pick up from the next video on. And yeah, until then, drive handy.